Well, hello folks, and what's been a watershed week in local government. Got to talk about the good things first, and we've had a fantastic two-day Queensland Treasury Corporation LGAQ Finance and Leadership Summit in Gladstone. Terrific program. Everyone who attended loved the new style of the 2 days, and it was a really good learning opportunity. But the big news this week has been the state government unveiling their proposed changes to the council's long-standing electoral system, from what we know as optional preferential voting to compulsory preferential voting. The LGAQ has also received a confidential cabinet and confidence briefing with respect to a suite of other changes which are just as big in their impact, but because of the conventions of cabinet and confidence, we're not able to discuss those with our members at this point in time. We have, though, written to the Premier. Our President, Mayor Mark Jamieson, yesterday implored the Premier to come clean, to give the community, not just councils or the LGAQ, a chance to have a say, to show the community the full extent of the reforms, the changes that they're proposing, so we can have a community debate. At the end of the day, whilst the LGAQ is important, it's our members, the 579 elected members, and indeed the community that really count the most. They're the people that should have the biggest say and be consulted on how the system's to work before this is legislated in April this year. Because of these big significant changes, the LGAQ policy exec will have a special meeting next Wednesday afternoon, the 6th of March. And the board of the LGAQ yesterday resolved to have a general meeting of the LGAQ on Tuesday, the 2nd of April in Brisbane. That's historic. It's very rare that we have a general meeting. If you like, I guess you'd call it a special meeting of council or a special conference. There'll only be the resolutions on the agenda relating to these changes and reforms, and there'll be none of the other things you'd expect at an annual conference. There'll be no trade, there'll be no entertainment. It'll simply be a half a day of discussion and debate around the motions that go to the heart of these changes. Every council will get two delegates, as they would at annual conference, and exercise the same votes you did at the 2018 LGAQ annual conference. It's a big move, but these are profound changes, very significant, that go to the heart of how our electoral system works. You need to be in charge. You need to be telling us what you want, and we're going to do that. You'll have your say on the 2nd of April. The LGAQ is very concerned about these changes. We believe that there needs to be a much broader debate rather than simply table the bills in Parliament, refer it to a parliamentary committee, and really be trying to deal with big changes after the fact, after they've been introduced, rather than before they're introduced. So we want councils to work with us to get the state government to give you the entirety of their agenda, to put it all on the table, to be upfront and open, and to have a public debate. You'll be hearing more from us shortly. Thank you.